shut up for several days for being naughty and long to be let out again. Late again. Edward laughed, and James fumed away. After James had finished his work, he went back to the yard and puffed onto the turntable. He was still feeling very bad-tempered. Edward is impossible, he grumbled to the others. He clanks about like a lot of old iron. And he is so slow he makes us wait. Thomas and Percy were indignant. Old iron? Slow? Why, Edward could beat you in a race any day. Really? Said James. I should like to see him do it. James's driver was suddenly taken ill. He could hardly stand, so the fireman uncoupled James ready for shunting. James was impatient.
Percy was too.
Suddenly the signalman shouted. There was James puffing away down the line. All traffic halted, he announced at last. Then he told the fireman what had happened. Two boys were on James's footplate, fiddling with the controls. Phew! They tumbled off and ran. When James started, the signalman answered the telephone. Yes, he's here. Right. I'll tell him. The inspector's coming at once. He wants a shunter's pole and a coil of wire rope. What for? Wondered the fireman. Search me, but you'd better get them quickly. The fireman was ready when Edward arrived. The inspector saw the pole and the rope. Good man,
good girl, jump in.
We'll catch him. We'll catch him, puffed Edward. James was laughing.
Percy was too.
What a lark, what a lark, he chuckled to himself. Suddenly he was going faster and faster. He realized that he had no driver. What shall I do? I can't stop. Help! Help! We're coming! We're coming, called Edward. Edward was panting up behind with every ounce of steam he had. At last he caught up with James. Steady, Edward, called his driver. The inspector stood on Edward's front, holding a noose of rope in the crook of the shunter's pole.
She was trying to speak to James's buffer.
The engine swayed and lurched. At last, got him, he shouted. He pulled the noose tight, gently braking. Edward's driver checked the engine's speed. And James's fireman scrambled across and took control. So the old iron caught you after all, chuckled Edward.
Excuse me,
whispered James. Thank you for saving me. You were splendid, Edward. That's all right.
I'm sorry, too.
The engines arrived at the station side by side. Sir Topham Hatt was waiting. Thank you.
Mister, excuse me, sir. Said Doc. Duck was delighted. It really is a pleasure to go out with him.